Do the voice calls by poor on-the-field process hinder you from having accurate reliability performance and lifetime estimation for advanced IC package? Is there any solution for this issue? Hello everyone, welcome back to the iST Ease Your Pen. I'm Laura, your hostess today. Nowadays, fine pitch technology has increasingly been applied on packages such as BGA and CSP. When the ball pitch is smaller than 0.25 millimeters, the stress from thermal and mechanical tests could cause cracks in fine pitch solder joints, which may lead to reliability problem. To cope with this problem, the industry will conduct the underfill process after SMT. In the underfill process, epoxide is dispensed at the edge of a chip and then fills up the gap between solder joints by capillary action. After the underfill is cured, it can improve the mechanical strength of solder joints and extend the service life of chips. Voids more or less may occur in the underfill process due to many factors, and may hinder the underfill from wrapping around the solder balls at chip bottom and lower the effectiveness of protecting solder joints. In this video, we will share two cases about where voids are most likely to appear in the underfill process and how they affect the reliability of chips. Subscribe to our channel now. We will continue to share our first-hand semiconductor information with you. We found that the flux residue from SMT process may block the path of underfill flow and obstruct the epoxide from filling up the chip bottom. The underfill process in this case could result in many voids. Therefore, we suggest performing flux cleaning to remove foreign matters and then bake the PCBA before moving on to the underfill process. The second common case is, as the chips are getting smaller due to advanced package process, the pitch between solder balls has also been reduced. The distance between the substrate and the die has shrunk to 10 to 30 micrometers. The smaller the pitch is, the slower the flow rate will be. This makes underfill harder to flow and wrap around each solder joint evenly, which eventually leads to voids. What will happen if voids form at the chip bottom? iST Reliability Lab performed tests and found that samples subjected to high temperature, humidity, and bias environment could induce the growth of dendrites along the underfill voids, which may result in solder ball bridging and abnormal resistance in the reliability tests. Therefore, a longer chip lifetime can be expected if without voids in the underfill. How to deal with annoying underfill voids? We introduce a vacuum pressure oven, which can adjust the vacuum and pressure parameters according to the viscosity of different underfills to achieve the best quality of zero void in the underfill process and prevent the voids from affecting the reliability test results. The underfill process we talk about today is frequently adopted by handheld devices, for example, PCBs in smartphone or tablet, as they have to go through demanding mechanical shock and vibration tests. Otherwise, the solder joints of chips are very likely to fail these two tests. If you have any inquiry for underfill process on a small batch of components, welcome to contact us. So that's a wrap for today. I hope you like our video. Bye-bye. iST Ease Your Pen, first-hand industry observation. If you like this video, please press like. If you want to see more, subscribe to our channel and turn on the notification bell so you won't miss any of our future videos.